Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2155. Generate multiple random results from one formula. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, in addition to the podcast and writing books, I write a monthly article for Strategic Finance Magazine. I was working on next month's article where I was showing them how to use Power Query to split a column of semicolon separated data to rows, and I needed to generate some fake data for that. And why I didn't open the file from episode 2097, I have no idea. I just wanted to create some fake data. So anywhere from 2 to 12 products in one cell. And in the process of doing that, I used a lot of tricks from the podcast. TEXTJOIN, fill, apple, banana, cherry, random walk, F4 to redo. And I think along the way, I discovered some interesting things of how to speed up this process. Now, first off, it would have been great if I could have just created one huge massive array formula that would have generated that data, and I could have copied that formula down, but I couldn't reach my copy of CTRL+SHIFT+ENTER, and I was just looking for something simpler that morning. I'm a big fan of RANDBETWEEN. I use RANDBETWEEN all of the time, so if we had a list of 12 products, and then here generated a series of answers using RANDBETWEEN, so the index of A1 to A12, asking for a random number from 1 to 12. Well, every time I press F9, I get a different list of products. And then I want a different number of products in each one, so here RANDBETWEEN 2 through 7 or 2 through 12 or whatever the upper limit is. And then using TEXTJOIN, that awesome new function in Office 365, separated by a semicolon, ignore the blanks, and then we're going from E2 right there down to anywhere in E2 to E12 based on the sixth value in this case, will generate that list. All right, but the reason I don't like this is that I kept pressing F9. See, I started getting repeats, and you know, allegedly this is orders coming from a website, and why would someone order elderberry? It just doesn't make sense, right? So I didn't like the chance there of getting date. I wanted to have a unique list. So here's what I decided that I was going to do. First off, I was going to create a list of the 12 products, and I have this memorized as a custom list, so I can just generate a nice alphabetic list of items. And then I wanted anywhere from 2 to about 7 of these. And so what I did here, as I say, equal if the rand. Rand is an awesome function that generates a decimal from 0 to 1 is less than 0.6. So in other words, in about 60% of the cases, I want you to bring that product over here to column B, otherwise give me nothing, quote. All right, and we'll copy that down. And what that's going to do for me is generate a list of products. There'll never be any repeats. There's no chance of any repeats. And every time I press F9, I get a different list of products. And yeah, it looks like we're getting, you know, the right number of products each time. All right, so now that we have that, the new function in Excel, in Office 365 is TEXTJOIN. I love this. The delimiter is going to be a semicolon, and then ignore empty. It doesn't matter. It really does matter here. That's the important thing. We're going to ignore empty true, and then here's our list of products like that. Okay, so there we are. We have our product list for the first row, but I need to generate a whole bunch of these, and this is where we actually get to the issue that I was trying to solve in this particular case. Now, if I would just copy that formula down, right, if I took that original formula and came here and edited this, choose the colon, press F4 to make sure that I have an absolute reference and copy it down, you'll see that I end up with identical items all the way down. It's not very interesting fake data, right? So that's not going to work. What I need to do is I need to take the result of this formula and create a whole bunch of them. All right, so initially, I did this. I did Control C, and then I come here and I'm going to do paste special values, or I guess that's just paste and paste values like that. All right. And what's fascinating to me, and I've talked about this once on the podcast before, and everyone in the YouTube comments was, well, of course that's going to work. No, what's fascinating to me is I copied cell C14, and so you would think that when I copied C14, the text from C14 would have been copied to the clipboard, but it's not. It's pointing to C14, right? So the first time that I paste, I got cherry, date, elderberry. But you now see that C14, the marching ants, has changed to apple, cherry, fig. And so I'm going to come down here and I'm going to paste values again. And I'm always shocked that it changed to the new value, right? So if I just could just paste values, it would generate a new answer every single time. This time when I paste values, apple, banana, date, fig, iceberg, jackfruit. But look, it's a hassle to grab the mouse and come up here and choose paste and choose values. So I'm going to use the awesome redo function, not undo, redo, which is F4. So F4, paste the new value. When I press F4 here, I get banana, date, elderberry, lime. So it's just simple. F4, down arrow, F4, down arrow, F4, down arrow. All right, and life is great. There, I have enough fake data for the article. All right, but even that is a hassle. All right, so the method that I learned from a good friend of mine who's now deceased, Professor Simon Beninga, taught me this. If we have a model, and this is essentially a model, that is using RAND or RAND between and generating, you know, a result, what you can do is you can have multiple versions of that result happen. All right, and we have to start from the cell to the left of the result of our model, choose that cell and the cell that contains your formula, and then however many you want. Let's say I needed 100 of these or 132 of these. Just copy or select all the way down, and we're going to come here to the data tab. The data tab. What if analysis, data table. All right. Now I use this all the time to show how to create multiple scenarios, but in this case, we don't really have anything for row input cell. For the column input cell, just choose any empty cell. It doesn't matter what cell it is. And this is going to run this model 132 times, each time essentially pressing F9 to generate new random values like that. Click OK, and bam, it works. I absolutely love that. Now, this is live. Every time I press F9, I get a new set of 132 of these. So just copy, Control-C, and come out here. Paste special values, and we have our fake list of products, and we're ready to essentially do what was back in episode 2097, split a column of x semicolon, x semicolon, x semicolon to rows. Highly recommend you check out that video. It's a great video, or the November issue, November 2017 issue of Strategic Finance Magazine. It'll be online in early November. All right, so all of these methods are in the book, Power Excel with Mr. Excel 2017 edition. Click that I in the top right-hand corner to check it out. Recap of what we talked about today. The goal is to create a sample data set with semicolon-separated products, always two or more products, up to a max of 12. So I stored a list of products in a custom list, so you can easily generate a single column of products. Using RAND between, that would have worked, but we have duplicates in the list. So I'm using the RAND function to say, is this product in or not? Then the TEXTJOIN function to concatenate the non-blanks with semicolons in between. But then the big question, now that you have one result, how do you make multiple results using the RAND function? Well, it's surprising that one copy and then multiple paste values will give you different answers because it's always recalculating after each paste. And you can speed that using F4 to redo the paste values. Not a bad way to go, but the super fast way, thanks to Professor Beninga, use the what if tools and a data table with an empty cell as the column input cells, and you'll be able to generate hundreds of random results very, very quickly. All right, there you go. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.